Welcome back, RPA champions. In today's video, we are going to be looking at the end game of all automation. Exactly. Claude has released something amazing, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to set it up on your computer and test it out on your computer. It is going to be something mind-blowing. After a decade in automation, I have never seen something so simple. It truly means the end of all work for humans in front of the computer. Sooner than later. So what is this big hype about? So Claude, a couple of days ago, released an upgrade to their model, Claude Sonnet 3.5. It became exponentially better at coding tasks, at vision, at all kinds of different tasks. And it just beats up any other model straight up, just like GPT-4, Gemini, and so forth. Not to talk about the open source model. Now, that is the update to Claude. However, there is another post that was released that is called Developing a Computer Use Model. So this is where Anthropic explains how they build this computer use case that we're gonna see in a second. They also mention of how this interaction with the computer is going to be more and more popular with human interaction with computers. So you say a couple of words of what you need to do and the computer does the rest. Now from this link right here, from this page, I was able to find the GitHub repo where we have all of the instructions that are required to set up this demo. I'm going to leave all of these links right here also. Also the custom link that I'm going to be using to connect to the virtual machine that was set up by Anthropic to allow us to test this amazing functionality. Without further ado, let's set this up for us to work on our computer. Now, the first thing that we're going to need is Docker. So I have already Docker installed. Now, to install Docker, it is a process, meaning that is really straightforward. You accept all of the default configuration, you go into the Docker page, and you just download it from Docker. You will need to create an account with your email address, but that's as complicated as it gets. What is Docker? Docker is an application or a software that is going to allow us to run virtual machines, amongst other things, on our computer. Now, once you have Docker installed, updated, and ready to go, what you're going to have to do is click here in the terminal. So what we're going to do is we're going to paste this command that we have right here in the Anthropic blog. So use, this is for AWS. So I think we have to use the Anthropic console. So let's see. So write this one. So this is the one that we're going to have to use. We're going to exchange this Anthropic key that we see right here with our own Anthropic key. Now, if you don't have an Anthropic key, you can get one for free. I think they're currently still having an offer for $5. So you would go to Anthropic, to the Anthropic console, and generate a new API key. So let me just move this out of the way. So right here, you have create a key. You would click on this, and let's create a key for this video. So let's call it test computer system. This is so cool. So cool, ladies and gentlemen. Let's copy this key and I will destroy this key after this demonstration. So I have taken my API key and that string, put it into Notepad so that I can work with it more easily. And let me just explain you what this does. So this runs a Docker instance. It sets some variables. So it says some environment variables. So it makes the Anthropic API key as an environment variable. Then it mounts a computer instance from this repo right here on GitHub. So on GitHub, they're hosting a virtual machine or an image or an instance of a machine. And we're just connecting to that machine, deciding which ports to keep open and the configuration that the machine is going to have. All right, so what do we have to do with that string? We're going to go back to Docker. Let's make this full screen. And very easily down here in the terminal, we're going to paste that command. After we paste it, we're going to hit on enter. And this, for you, if you're running it for the first time, it is going to download all of the virtual machine, the requirements, and so forth. So it might take a little bit of time depending on your internet connection. It is not huge. I think it's just a few gigabytes of storage, if even. It is just basically a very simple virtual machine. Now we can use this virtual machine on our local host. So you see that computer use demo is ready. We can click on local host right here. So let's click on it and see what happens. We are almost here. Oh my God, this is it. imagine when this is going to be rolled out to everybody. You're going to have an app that installs on your computer and that allows you to pretty much do whatever you're doing right now in front of the computer. That is not entertainment, work, any kind of work. How does it work? So this virtual machine that you see right here has some apps, has a terminal, Firefox, images, PDF, Excel, I think Word, calculator. So these are the apps that it has available. So what is it doing? It takes screenshots of your computer browser, passes them to Claude. Claude looks at the screenshot, decides based on the pixels where what is happening in the screenshot, and then based on the pixels, it positions the mouse on those places. That's not it. Also, when it needs to make a use a different application, like one of these applications, it will make a trigger for that application based on the context that the user is asking. So if you have to create a summary of the best-selling cars in Italy, it would understand that it needs a spreadsheet where to collect and save this information. But let's pause on this functionality. Let's get it to work and see how it works in practice. So before starting, here we have a couple of different options. So we have Anthropic, Bedrock, and Vortex. We also have the ability to change the model, and we can't forget to put in our API key right here. After we have done all of that, we can click on Reset. This is going to reset our server, it is going to relaunch, and we are going to be ready to roll in a couple of seconds. So let's think about this. What are we going to have this AI do? Now, I've tried plenty of tasks. You have to keep in mind also that it does use quite a bit of tokens still, because tokens are not getting, conversation is not getting cached, there's just images, the images are changing all of the time. It doesn't stop, if it can't break this automation, because it's constantly feeding screenshots and it's never going to stop until it completes the task. So it is really cool, really interesting, lots of potentials. Let's see it in action. So I've used it already for quite a bunch of things, but I am looking to buy a car in Italy, and I would like to find a great deal for a, what car should we get for a, let's say Audi, for an Audi A. All right, we are ready to just send this command to this autonomous agent and see what it does. Let's launch this. So what is happening? Claude AI has received this. It has taken a screenshot. It understood the concept or the context of what I have written inside of it. And now it's just taking screenshots, understanding where the mouse is, understanding what to click on. So now it is clicking on Firefox. Let's see what it's going to do. I guess it's going to do like a Google search for top cars or cars in Italy or something similar. It is taking more screenshots. Let's see it here. We see that it's taking more screenshots. It is going to the search console. So I guess it is going to go to Google or to some search engine. No, it is going to autoscout.it. Now that is that. Wow, that is brilliant. I have no idea how it knew to go to the best website to find cars in Italy. Thumbs up for you to that. I was expecting actually just a basic Google search. And on the Google search, I was thinking that it was going to find me some cars, but it actually was able to find the place where I would go look for cars instead of doing a Google search. But is it stuck here? So let's see if it's stuck here. Did it get stuck with, no, it did not get stuck. It is still processing. It is, so what did we ask? We asked for an Audi A3. So it's taking more screenshots, and based on the screenshots, it is calculating the pixels on the page, and based on the pixels, it knows where to move the mouse, what to click, and what decision to do. Obviously, as I was saying before, this takes up loads of tokens, because every few seconds a screenshot is sent, also some text is sent with the screenshot to understand where it makes the most sense to click. So right now it clicked on the, it selected Audi. I have no idea if it is going to make it and be able to select the model as well. but let's see what happens. And just imagine this inside of your work. Let's say you have to prepare a report, you have to do any kind of work that you're doing in front of the computer. Soon you're going to give it a list, or an AI, or your boss, or whoever. It is going to give it a set of instructions, or even you, a set of instructions, and it will perform those instructions while you're walking your dog, going to the gym, playing, or just looking for another job, because people will not be working in front of the computer anymore. It looks like robots are going to be working in front of the computer. And yeah, I know with technology things change really fast. However, things right now are changing so fast that I don't think that there is going to be a speedy enough recovery of new job opportunities based on all of that have been lost due to automation and due to this kind of technologies. So we see that it is going, that it has gone quite a lot long way in the process, that it has found quite a few cars. Let's see, let's keep it going, and let's see what kind of deal is it going to find for me. Also remember that if I wanted to create this automation using something like Microsoft Power Automate Desktop or Python, in a low code, no code automation tool, it would have taken me some time. If you don't know how to use the tool, you would have a learning curve to learn how to use the tool. But with this technology, even a small child can perform pretty much any operation. Now, what would happen if I ask it to make me, or to make, generate $1,000 or something a little bit more complex? Is it going to continue until it has, or now it's going on another website? What the hell? How does it know? Like, really, seriously, how does it know to go to Subito IT? I didn't even think about it. That's great, it's a brilliant idea. So it went to Auto Scout and then it went to Subito IT. My goodness, we are so getting automated and replaced. But anyways, ladies and gentlemen, this is it. My next prompt is going to be to ask it to make me $1,000 while I go for a walk. All right, so now you know how to create agents and how to create agents that use your computer for you. If you have liked this video, and if you appreciate the kinds of video that I make, if you stayed with me for so long, be cool and subscribe to the RPA channel. Only cool people that are on the front of automation are subscribed to my channel. And if you want to be one of them and not miss any of my videos and be part of the community, don't forget to subscribe, leave a comment down below, and let's start a conversation. So my goodness, here it is continuing. It is really going insane. I have to quit this video because this is way too much. I have way other queries to ask it on how to make money and other things like that. See you in the next video. Thanks for watching.